Hi, welcome to clickmeproject.com. This video will lead us to the demo of secure data sharing in cloud computing using revocable storage identity based encryption. Cloud computing provides a flexible and convenient way for data sharing, which brings various benefits for both the society and individuals. But there exists a natural resistance for users to directly outsource the shared data to the cloud server, since the data often contain valuable information. Thus, it is necessary to place cryptographically enhanced access control on the shared data. Identity-based encryption is a promising cryptographical primitive to build a practical data sharing system. However, access control is not static. That is, when some users' authorization is expired, there should be a mechanism that can remove him from the system. Consequently, the revoked user cannot access both the previously and subsequently shared data. To this end, we propose a notion called revocable storage identity-based encryption, which can provide the forward or backward security of ciphertext by introducing the functionalities of user revocation and ciphertext update simultaneously. Furthermore, we present a concrete construction of RSIBE and prove its security in the defined security model. The performance comparisons indicate that the proposed RSIBE scheme has advantages in terms of functionality and efficiency, and thus is feasible for a practical and cost-effective data sharing system. Finally, we provide implementation result of the proposed scheme to demonstrate its practicability. First of all, the data owner have to register and log into the system, and also the user have to register into the system. Then the data owner select the data and encrypts the selected data. Then the data owner have to set the access control, that is the permission to access the data for the users. Then the data is transferred to CSP, that is cloud service provider. Then the user one login into the system and then receives the data from cloud service provider, then decrypts the data. Then the user one have to exit from the group. Then the cloud service provider re-encrypts the data that is present in that. Then the user 2 have to login into the system and then receive the data from cloud service provider. And then the received data is to be decrypted by the user 2. Let us see the demo of secure data sharing in cloud computing using revocable storage identity-based encryption. First of all, right-click the homepage.java and then select run file option. Now press this image. Then the user have to log in here. For that, user have to enter username and password. If the user want to register means, then click register and then the user can register. Press login. Now the login is success for that particular user. Press select. Now the data is selected by the data owner. The file name, location, and then the format, and then the size of the data is displayed here. Press the view button. Here we can see the selected data, that is the content of the selected data. And then press next. Then press generate. Now the key is displayed here. This key is used for encryption. Now press encryption button. Now the selected data is encrypted, and then press next. Now the access control is set for the data. First of all, the names should be selected from this list. These are the two users can have permission to access this data. Press receive data. The storage server have received this data, and then click next. Now the user one, this is the user one. Here the user have to login there, login by using the username and password. then press login. Now the login is success, and then we have to check whether this user have permission to access this data or not. Check access control. This is authorized user, so the user can access this data. Then press receive data. Now the user have received this data, and then decrypt data. Now the data is decrypted. Then press exit. If the exit button is pressed, means this user have exited from this group. Then we have to run storageserver.java. Right click the storageserver.java and select run file option. Press view encrypted data. This is the encrypted data that is present in the storage server. Press re-encryption. The encrypted data is again encrypted by this. Then click next. Now this is the second user. This second user have to log in by using the username and password. Press login. Now the user is logged into the system, and then here we have to check the access control for access the data. Press check access control. This user have the authorization permission, so the user too have to receive the data. This data is decrypted two times, so that we have to press decrypt data. Here the data, that is this received data, is decrypted twice, and then we can see the original content. This is the original content. This original content is not visible for the user 1, because the user 1 receives the data that is encrypted only once, but this is encrypted twice, so that we have to decrypt twice.